yesterday we saw the security, right? That is we learned about the security, how to implement security in Spring Boot application, how to enable security, how to customize the security, how to add the roles. We have seen a lot of things yesterday. Then finally, we did one basic authentication where we are going to do our own authorization, own authentication. Using this code, it will authenticate the user. If it is valid user, it will allow to manipulate, otherwise it will give error. Okay. Now, today we are going to see JWT. JWT is a one more authorization techniques. It's a more powerful authorization techniques. Okay. Today we are going to see how to integrate JWT authentication in our Spring Boot application. Okay. Before going into the code, first we need to understand what is JWT. We need to understand that. Okay. JWT is nothing but a JSON web token. It's a JSON web token. It's a big string. It's a big encrypted string. Which generated by
Suresh, I'm not able to hear you.
Is it? Oh. Okay, yeah. You able to see the screen? Are you able to see the screen?
Oh, yes.
Okay. Okay. I hope you people understand whatever we saw yesterday, right? Spring security, how to enable Spring security, how to customize Spring security, how to configure roles and authentication, those things we went through. Okay. We did one basic authentication. Through that basic authentication, we have validated the username and the password. If it is valid, it allow to further manipulation, otherwise it will throw there. This is what we did yesterday through Spring security. Okay. Today we will go to see how to improve the security mechanism further. Okay. There are many authorization process available in Spring Boot in which one of the popular authorization mechanism is a JWT, JSON web token. JWT nothing but a JSON web token. JWT nothing but JSON web token. It is a big encrypted string. Okay. This string contains three sections. I will tell you. Okay. One is header, payload and the signature. For example, in a postman, this is a JWT string. Okay, it's an encrypted string. When you look at here, it has three sections. It has a three section separated by dot. Okay. This is one section. This is one section. Okay. It has a three sections. The first section we call it as a header section. Second one we call it as a payload. Payload section or clients. We can say payload or clients. Third section is a signature section. This three section is called as a combination of this three section is called as a JWT token, JSON web token. This string generated by server side, based on the client information, it will generate this string generated by server side. Then server give this as a response to the client. client can should keep this information their side whenever they wanted to perform any manipulation, perform call any rest endpoint. They have to send the string. They have to send the string to the server. Server decrypt the string and check these are right client. These are right client or not, or this particular token is already expired or not. So it will check this token is valid or not. If it is valid, then it will send back to the proper response. Otherwise, it will give the error. Okay, this is called this process is called as an authorization process, authentication process for JWT. Okay, we'll go and check further. Now I'll go to decrypt this. Let's see what's happening when decrypt this. Why we are calling it as a JWT? Why we are calling it as a JWT? That I will tell. There is one site called JWT IO. I am pasting that string here. Once you pasted the string, you can see here. It has a decoded value. Decoded value has a three section: decoded, payload, and a verify signature. It has a three. When we should decode this, we are getting three part. One is a header section. Second one is a payload section. Third one is a signature section. The header section says that what is the algorithm we are using to generate this string. Then second section is payload section. Payload section is a JSON, again it's a JSON structure. JSON structure, okay. In this section, we can add anything. We can add all our client details. Here, sub nothing but user. Sub nothing but user who is logged in. Country is, I have added this. By default, this particular section contains sub expiration and IAT. Sub expiration and IAT. Okay, sub expiration diet. Sub means username who is logged in. Then exp means expiration. When this token get expire, this is a long time format. This is a long time format. When this particular attribute tell that when this token get expired. IAT nothing but issued at nothing but when this token issued to the client. When this token issued, that is when this token generated. Okay, this information available payload section. Apart from this particular attribute, if you want, you can add your client specific data. If you want, you can add some client specific data. For example, I want to know request coming from which country. In that case, you can say country code. In that case, you can say country code. For example, if you have a server, that server have multiple type of client. Now each client have some unique client ID. That client ID we can give here. So whatever information, client information you want to provide, that particular data we can put in payload section. Combination of these two section generating one signature section, that is called as this one. Okay, here header and the payload, by through this section it's generating on the signature. The third section is a signature section that's generated from header and the payload. This is the JSON structure. So this encrypted string giving us a JSON structure, right? That's the reason we are saying JSON web token. The reason we are calling it as a JSON web token, whenever decrypt, whenever encode this particular JSON string, it will generate the, it will give us a JSON structure. That is the reason we call it as a JSON web token. This JSON web token used to authenticate particular client. Okay, now we'll go to, in this section we'll go to see how to generate this access token, how to generate this JWT token, how to use this JWT token for authentication purpose. Okay, now if this is a JWT token, right? JSON web token. In this JSON web token, we have a two section. We have a two type. One is a access token, another one is a refresh token. One is a access token, another one is a refresh token. What is access token? Whenever client sending their information, For example, they are sending username, password, country code, client ID, whatever information they are sending to the server for authentication. Server read that value, generate one token, that is an access token. Along with that token, it will generate one more token, it's a refresh token. Both are same only. Only difference is short lifetime. This having a long lifetime. It can be long lifetime. Okay. Both token is having an expiration date. This token we have to generate with short lifetime. This token we have to generate with long lifetime. Okay. Now we have to generate these two tokens using JWT. Once generated, we will give these two tokens to the client side. We will give two tokens to this client side. Client keep this token somewhere else in secure manner. Whenever client want to access any API, client send access token to the server. Server read that access token, verify it. If that access token is valid or not. If it is valid, allowed to client to further manipulation. If it is not valid, it's a throw the error. If it is the access token expired, if this is short lifetime, right? If that access token is expired, what will happen? Server tells that your access token is expired. I cannot authenticate using this expired token. It will give something, it will give error message like to the client. Now, next step is client want to generate a new access token. How to generate new access token? Okay, client tell that once receive the message from the server side, your access token expired. Client immediately send the refresh token to the server. Okay, please generate access token. I am sending this refresh token. Verify this refresh token. If the refresh token is valid, I want new access token for further manipulation. So it will send the refresh token to the class server. Server verify the refresh token. If it is valid, it will generate a new access token. And send the access token to the client again. Now client, from now on, they'll keep the new access token. From using that new access token, they will going to call subsequent web service. This is the life cycle. Okay. They have a two token, access token and a refresh token. Access token for regular endpoint call. Whenever a call endpoint, they have to send the access token. Through that access token, they can invoke a particular rest point. Whenever access token expired, client send the refresh token back to the server. Using that refresh token, server generate the new access token, then provide to the client. Client use this access token for further manipulation. There is another scenario. Access token is expired. A client sending the refresh token. Let's say refresh token also expired. Now server cannot generate access token because refresh token also expired. These are long lifetime when compared to access token. But anyway, one day it will go and expire, right? What will happen that time? If expired, what will happen again? Client has to provide username and the password. Again, client has to provide all the details: username, password, country code, client ID, whatever they want. Server is expecting. They have to send. Then client verify all the details and generate access token and the refresh token. Give back to the client. Okay, this is the life cycle. Okay, now we'll going to see how to generate the access token. Not only access token, both. We'll going to generate how to authorize. Based on the client detail, I want to authorize the client. Then I want to generate access token and a refresh token. We'll going to see that now. This is the yesterday program. With the yesterday program, we are using basic authentication. We are using basic authentication. We are taking the authorization details from the header. Okay. You know what I am doing here. Here, this code implemented in filter, right? This code implemented in filter. According to this program, whenever try to execute any endpoint by the client, at that time I am checking username and password is valid or not. Username and password valid or not. If it is valid, I am allowing him to further manipulation. Okay. But in the case of JWT, it's not like that. There is a two places I will do authenticate. Two places. One is login. They have to login. Through that login credential, the server will check that client information is valid or not. If it is valid, we'll going to generate access token and refresh token. That is a login mechanism. Once that generated, using login, if we generated the access token, refresh token, both will go to the client side. Once go to the client side, client use that access token to further subsequent web service call. That time we need to write a filter. In that filter, we need to validate that particular token is valid or not. Understand? There's a two place we need to authenticate. One is login by providing username and a password. Using that, we are generating the token. After that, for each subsequent call, we need to send the token. Client will send the token. Using the token, we have to authorize in the filter. Okay. Here, this line is the authentication line, right? This is the authentication manager to authenticate. I am passing username and a password. This particular line, we have to implement different place. That is login place. I'll go to this project. Let me explain about this project overall. Okay. So far clear? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Here I created a user control. One user control. The user control, as usual, I have a regular endpoint method. This endpoint method I want to access publicly. This kind of registration I want to access public manner. This endpoint I want to access only after authentication. This is my intention. Okay, what I am doing here? Authentication, security context loader, get context, get authentication. Then from the security context, I am printing currently logged in, currently accessing username and the password. Username. And is, yeah, just I am printing currently who is requesting the endpoint. After successful executing the REST endpoint, I want to know who is that user. That user information I am printing here. Okay, I will explain this code later. You will understand after explaining this particular JWT implementation. Okay, this particular endpoint is returning currently available user. Okay, that is the purpose of this particular endpoint. Okay, then there is another controller, authentication controller, right? This authentication controller, API authenticate, it has an endpoint called API authenticate. Here I am mentioning on post mapping. In that post mapping, one method called authenticate. That authenticate method accepting a request body called authentication request info. Authentication request info. Here we can say username, password, and a refresh token. I am having a three attribute: username and a password, refresh token. As of now, we are not dealing with refresh token. Okay, we are dealing with only username and a password. The client must log in using that username and a password. So they have to provide username and password. We have to capture that username password from the client side, right? So I'm capturing that username and password using authentication request info. Okay. Then what I am doing here? Authentication manager dot authenticate, I am saying. I'll come to this code later. Okay. I want to explain generally about this project. Okay. This is for authenticate. This is like a login screen, login API. You, That is, your client has to provide username and a password. That username and password validated by this particular endpoint. Okay. Then, now we need to configure security properly, right? Like yesterday, what we did. For that, I created one more class called security config. Security config that extends from web security configurator. Then it's at enable web security. I enabled it with at enable web security. Their authentication service. When you look at this authentication service, it's extended from user detail. It is extended from user detail. Yesterday, one difference from this code. Yesterday, I have not used the user repository. Yesterday example, I have not used user repository, but here I am using user repository because I want to get the username and the password from the database. Yesterday we hard coded. Yesterday we hard coded. Okay. So that the user, I declared user repository. User is a entity object. User is a entity object. Entity object, I mapped with user table. I mapped with the user table which is available in the database. Okay, that user repository I am using in authentication service that implements user detail service. Then JWT utils, I'll explain later about this. Then password encoder also I am not using it here. Okay, that is also I am not using it, I think. No, this is no need. So in this class, we are seeing one additional class called user repository because I want to take user information from the database. I don't want a hard code now. Here, I am overriding one method called load by username. Load by username by providing email ID. While providing email ID, what I am doing here, yesterday code, just I am hard coding here, but instead of that, one more additional line I added here. One more additional line. User repository dot find user by email ID. Find user by email ID. When you look at this user repository, I have implemented that method user find by user email ID. This we have to follow some naming convention here. Okay. Find is a we have to use. Then user. User is a our entity object. Then by which you want to find. This is a mandate. Find user by. Then by which column you want to, by which column you want to find the user. I want to find the user by this email ID. Whatever attribute I have given here, that attribute you have to mention. So what is the syntax here? I want to find user. So I put find. Then which object you want to find? User object. User object by which column? By which attribute? Email ID. Which is available in the user object. Then I must be caps. Then we need to pass parameter string email ID. Okay, now automatically for this method, JBase generate a query. JBase generate a query. For that query, return. That query return user object. That query return user object. That user object I am capturing here. That user object I am capturing here. Then I want to populate this user data inside a user details, inside a user detail which is coming from Spring Boot, which is coming from Spring Boot security framework. Then equal to new user. This is not our custom user. This user is coming from again Spring Boot. Okay, that is the reason here I specified com.itgarden.entity.user. This is our own user. Using this user, I am fetching user detail from the database, then assigning to the user object. Then here I am populating user detail equal to new user of this user dot get email ID, this user dot get password. Then there is no security, there is no roles for this user. Then the assigning that user detail here. Okay. So in this method implementation, I am telling take the user data from user repository. Yesterday we hard coded. Where is that? authentication service. Okay, now you understand that what is a load by username. Load by username. Okay, now I'll come to that authentication control. I will explain this later. So those methods are all JWT related thing. Okay, I will explain it later. Okay. Whenever user want to authenticate, user should use API/authenticate, right? API/authenticate. That time, this method get invoke. This method get invoke. Now this particular request object having a username and a password. Username and a password. Authentication manager is a Spring Boot API, Spring Boot security API. Using that API, I am saying authentication manager dot authenticate. Authentication manager dot authenticate. Then I am passing username and a password in the form of username password authentication token. Now this authenticate method validate given username and a password, which is loaded from database. This is coming from client. This is coming from client. Whenever say like this, what will happen? This authenticate call this authentication service and call this method. Call this method and get that user information by this username. This username is email ID only. Okay, by this username and validate that username and the password with this username and the password. If it is valid, it will come to here. It will come to here. It will come to here. Okay, otherwise it will go to the exception block. Otherwise it will go to exception block. Then if it is success, what I am doing, authentication service dot again I am calling load user by name using that username. Now it will return that user detail here, that return that user detail here. Up to this line you are clear, I believe, because we have done this code yesterday, part of basic authentication. When you look at this project, right, go here, the same thing I am doing. After decrypting the username and password, authentication manager authenticate, authenticating the username and the password, then after authenticate, I am loading that username. Loading the username, then after loading, I am setting that user detail in the security context for future use. This is the code we have seen yesterday. The same code I am using here, the same code I am using in the authentication controller also. The same code I am using in the authentication controller also. Up to this line, the same code which we have seen yesterday. After this, now we have authenticated, user is good. From now on, we need to bind this user inside a JWT. We need to work with JWT now. We need to work with the JWT. Here, authentication service dot generate auth response. I am saying generate auth response. This is one method that implemented in authentication service. The authentication controller, after successful loading, I am passing this user detail inside the authentication service dot get auth response. Get auth response, right? Now this user detail contain username and password. Username and password. I want to using in this code implementation generating a JWT token. This code implementation is a generating a JWT token. Okay, I will tell one by one now. These are JWT utils. JWT utils, it has some utility method. Using that method, we can generate a JWT token. Okay, if you want to work with this util method, we have to add one form artifact. We have to add one artifact called io.json web token. We have to add this artifact. Without this artifact, we cannot work with JWT. Okay. Now this user detail can use the detail. Here I am saying JWT utils dot generate access token. From this class, this is a util class to generating a access token, right? I am saying JWT utils dot generate access token. When you go inside this method, what is there? I am passing user detail. This is a hash map. I'm creating an hash map. This is a payload. In that website, in the JWT IO, right, we saw one payload. I said payload section. This is a payload section, right? Sub EXIAT. Okay. This information I am generating here. generate access token. Using this user detail, I am generating access token. Before generating access token, first we need to generate our map object. This map object, we can call it as a claims. Claims. Okay. In the JSON, we are calling as a payload. This claims, nothing but a payload. The claims object, nothing but a payload. Okay. Now I want to generate that payload. Now here I am calling one more method called create token. One more method called create token. Here I am passing this initialized hash map. Then I am passing user detail dot get username. Whatever user I validated in authentication controller, I am passing that username. Then I am passing the empty client inside a create token. Okay. When you look at the inside a create token, I am saying JWT. JWT is coming from JWT library builder. It uses a builder pattern to build that client, build that payload. Builder set claims. I am setting these claims, that is hash map. Then I'm setting this empty hash map. Then in that hash map, I am adding subject. Subject is a, what is subject here? Subject is a username. Subject is a username. That is the standards you have to follow. Subject is a username. I am passing subject is a username. Then set issue dat. Set issue dat, nothing but I am saying here current day, current date and time. When this token generated, that is a issue dat. Then set expiration. Set expiration, nothing but I am here. Here we need to set the when this token want to expire. That part we need to tell. Set expiration. New date of system dot current time is plus access token expiration date. That is, this will return current date and time. From that current date and time, I want to expand some more time to make it available this particular token. This access token expiration coming from where? I am declared as a one of the variable here. Long access token expiration. Then this is coming from particular property file. Particular property file. What is that property file? It is a application.yaml file. Here see jwt.access-token-expiration. When you go here, you can, here I defined jwt.access-token-expiration. I given some long format number, 50 lakhs, 5 lakhs, something I given. I want to add some more time. I want from the current time to, I want to add some more time. Okay. This property I am taking from here. This property I am taking from here. Then I am accessing this property through this variable. While creating a token, from the current time, I am adding this access token expiration. This is 5 lakhs, right? The 5 lakhs will add here. Then sign in with, sign in with, sign with signature algorithm H2256. Then I am passing one more secret key. That secret key, that is your own key. You can pass anything here. This secret key also I am taking from application YAML file, secret key hyphen secret I am giving. Okay, in the real time they are going to give some complex number here. Okay, complex key here. So in the JWT util create token, what I am doing, I am passing the claims, empty claims hash map, then passing the username. Using this claims and username, in this client, I'm adding the username, then generating the currently issued time, then generating the expiration date, and generating the signature. Generating the signature. This method I'm calling here, right? This method calling here inside a generate access token. This generate access token, where I'm calling here? Authentication controller. After successful validating the particular username and the password, I'm loading a user detail. And assigning to user detail object, then authentication service dot, I'm calling generate auth response. This generate auth response use JWT token to generate the access token. Similarly, it use the JWT utils generate refresh token. Similarly, grant access, generate access token, I am generating a refresh token also. The very same code I'm using it. Okay. So this generate auth response, generating access token, generating refresh token. Then I want to give this information to client side. So I want to generate one response object. That response object is a authentication response info. Authentication response info is a response object that I created. If you look at this class, you can say access token, refresh token, access token expiration, refresh token expiration. Okay. I'm initializing that particular response object. Whatever access token I generated, I'm setting into the response object. Similarly, I'm setting it to refresh token also response object. Then while generating this access token, we are adding expiration date right here. Set expiration, we are adding that expiration date. I want to send that expiration date also to the client side. Okay. Now this expiration date value is available. It's everything's available inside a client. Once you generate it, once you call this method, it will create
Here in the line number 69, JWT.builder.setClaims, we are claims is a map object, right, sir?
Yeah.
What's happening? Can you explain after that the dot set object how it is setting to that map?
That is done by your JWT library. Okay, we have to pass for empty hash map. It keeps that hash map to populate the whatever data we are setting. For example, set claims. Here I am passing empty claims. You agree with this? These empty claims, empty hash map. Then at the moment you are saying set object, set subject. That subject adding into claims. That set issue that. That's the issue that adding it to claims hash map. Then this set expiration adding it to this claims object. While adding this set of set subject, it will add one key. While decoding, you can see here, right? Sorry, guys. Sub exp IAT, right? This key is generated by this particular JWT builder. In the builder, I am passing this hash map. Then for subject, I am passing the username. For this username, one key will generate. That key is the sub. So that hash map will have one key called sub. That sub having a value called the subject. Then set issue that. When you say set issue that, using the set issue that, we are generating one key called IAT. For that IIT, I am adding a current date and time. Then while saying set expiration, it will generate one key called EXP. For that EXP, I am saying when this token expired. You clear now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, through this builder pattern, we are generating that claims object by passing empty hash map. Okay, like that we can pass anything, whatever you want to pass, client information. For example, I want to pass country code, I want to pass client ID. If you want to pass country code, we can do like this.
Sir, duplicate values, it will accept or it will not accept, sir, this hash map?
It will not accept.
Okay, sir.
Okay, now go back to authentication controller. Go back to here. Now, in this code, right, the JWT value, I'm going to close all the things. In this JWT, we are setting that expiration date in the claims hash map, right? I want to access that claims object. Okay. After invoking this method, after calling this method, the claims object contains the expiration date. Okay. So, when you look at that authentication controller class, generate auth response. In the auth response info, I have one method called set access token expiration. Set access token expiration from the JWT. There is one utility method called extract expiration. We have one utility method called extract expiration. That extract expiration give when this token expires, that particular date it will be returned by this method. Okay, I'm using this method to extract that expiration date. JW util dot get extract expiration date. We have to pass access token. From this access token, it is extracting that expiration date. That give us a date object. I want to convert the date object as a local datum, because in the authentication response, I'm saying here local datum. That is the reason I want to convert this extract expiration return date format. I want to convert that as a local date time. Okay. So from here, from the date object, I'm calling a get time. From the get time, I am converting as a local date time. See here, instant dot epoch my millis. Through this method, I am converting the particular date object to local date time. Okay. Through this method, I am converting. This is not expiration date. This is coming from refresh token. This authentication response having an access token expiration, refresh token expiration. Okay. This both expiration date I am taking from extract expiration. From that expiration method, I am extracting the particular that expiration date and converting that expiration date as a local date time. Okay. 1 minute. I want expiration. Okay. I think your client dot. Yeah, we have to use wrong. We have to define one more method here. That code is wrong. While extracting issue data. Okay, we need to say issue data. IAT. Then get issue data. You have to say get issued at extract issued at. In the service, I want to say here extract issued at. Okay. If you don't understand this particular line, I will make it separate line. Okay. Local date time. Expiration date. Local data. In this line, from JWT utils extract expiration date, I am passing the access token. From this access token, it is taking the date which is expiration date. Now I want to convert this expiration date as a local date. For that, I am saying instant dot epoch milli, then I am passing this expiration date. Date get time. Okay, now I think you make it clear. Okay, then I want to set this expiration date in my response object. Okay. Okay, I leave this as it is. Okay, now you understand this line, right? Okay. So the authentication control, after authentication, I am loading the username, user details. Then after loading the user details, I am generating a JWT token. I am generating a JWT token. While generating a JWT token, I am setting what is the username and when this particular token is generated and when what is the expiration date of the particular token. This is the implementation to generate the JWT token. Okay. Now next one is okay. Now we'll see it's generating token or not. Okay. This is only for authorization. This is only for authorization. After generating token, we need to use the token for further subsequent web service call. That piece is available in the filter class. So we started now. What is our endpoint? Endpoint is API authenticate. API authenticate. The MySQL, I already created a username password. Let me open MySQL. In the configuration file, I am connecting training-db. Okay, training-db. Here you can see one table called user. It has a suresh@gmail.com 123 and the role is a user. Now I want to log in through this user, suresh@gmail.com 123. Okay. Where is the postman? Yeah, it is there already. Now I'll go to send a request. I got the response. Okay, I got the response. See, this is my response access token, refresh token, access token expiration, refresh token expiration. Okay. Now I'm going to take this string, copy it. There is another endpoint right here in the controller class. What is that endpoint? User controller, we have a profile. User data, it's a profile, it's a get mapping, right? It's a get mapping. Let me try that get mapping. Yeah, here. This is a get mapping, no need this request body. Even if it is there, no problem. It says forbidden error. It's not allowing to access because I'm not passing the authorization part. See, there is a token, but it's not a valid token. Let me give some junk data also. It won't come. It gives the error, right? So we need to use this particular token. FUK is instead FU1K, right? So FU1K. Now I'll go to send. Now you got currently logged in user suresh@gmail.com. Currently logged in user suresh@gmail.com. Using post mapping, I generated the token. Username says suresh@gmail.com, password is 123. Then I am retrieving this information using this profile. I am saying currently logged in user suresh@gmail.com. Okay, that is imprinting. How am I imprinting that? Let's check that. Whenever call this endpoint, what will happen? Filter method will go into invoke. That piece I will go to explain now. Okay. Then we'll come to this part. I will explain this. In the security config, you can see here in the configure method. In the configure method, I am saying authorize request ant matcher. API/authenticate /API/authenticate /API/user. These two URL permitted by everybody. Anyone can access. Yesterday method, what I did in the configuration class. I have not given like that. I want to authenticate everything. According to this configuration, I am saying that whatever URL coming, please authenticate. If it is valid, then allow. But here I am not saying like that. Here I am saying allow this to user to everybody. Anyone can access. Why I am saying like that? If you want to register the user, I want to provide access to the user. Okay. Through this endpoint, when you look at the user controller, API/user, when using this particular endpoint, they can add a customer, add a user. So if you want to add user, you don't have to provide any credentials, right? It's a publicly we can access the endpoint, they can add the user. For that purpose, I am saying this, allow this endpoint, permit all means anyone can access. Also authenticate. If you want to log into the system, that particular URL also, particular endpoint also should be accessed by public manner. So I am saying API/authenticate URL must be publicly accessible. In the authentication controller, API/authenticate, whenever call this endpoint by using post mapping method, this method get executed. And we need to pass username and password in the request body, it will validate. So definitely this particular method must be public, right? So I am saying here, allow this URL also publicly. In this configuration, I am saying authorize request. These two endpoints must be accessible in public manner. Then apart from these two URL, authenticate any request coming apart from this URL. If it comes any request, please authenticate. I am saying, okay. For that reason, whenever I call this method, it's not allowing to access. After providing JWT token, then only I'm able to access, right? Then after doing this configuration, I am saying http://addFilterBefore JWT filter. I'm passing my own filter, then passing username, password, authentication filter. Before calling this filter, I want to invoke this filter. Okay. Now let's go into this filter. Again, here it's a yesterday program, the same yesterday program only. Okay. There are some slight difference. Yesterday we have, through this authorization header, we have taken the basic authentication, that is username and password we have accessed, we have retrieved through this header. Now in the today program, in the header we are passing authorization bearer, it's a bearer type, bearer, then JWT, then we have to pass this JWT token. Okay. Through this authorization header, we are taking that JWT token. Jerry token. Here I am checking if it is not null. It is not start with bearer. If this condition satisfied, I am substring that method. I am taking only access token. Now we have got the access token. We have access token. Now from this access token, we need to validate that user is valid or not. The JWTUtils method, it has one method called extract username. Using this method, we can extract username which is available in the access token. Okay, 1 minute. Actually, it will extract this data. Okay, get extract username, go here, say subject, claims.get subject. That meaning it returning the user, returning the username. In the filter class, I returning that username. After returning that username, I am loading that username from the database. If that username available in the database, it will assign that user object, otherwise exception will throw. Once load that user detail, now populating that user detail in that username authentication token class, username password authentication token class. After populating username details, this username password authentication token, I am setting this object in the security context loader. Through this two line, I am setting this user information in the context loader. Whenever call any endpoint, each and every time when I call that endpoint, this piece of code execute, valid extract the username from the access token. Then we are getting the access, username from the access token. That username I am loading from the database. If that user is available in the database, it will come to here. Then it set that username in the security context using this two line. After setting that user information security context, I can access the particular user data, the respective endpoint, which endpoint you called. That respective endpoint, I can access the particular username. So in our example, in the user controller, I am calling this slash profile endpoint. Whenever I call this slash profile endpoint, I am passing my access token part of the header object, right? So the filter class execute extract that access token, validate that username, then finally that set that user information in the security context. After setting that, before executing this profile object, the security filter get execute and set that user information in the security context loader. Now I want to take that user information from the security context. For that, here I am saying your authentication.get principle. Here authentication, security context holder, get context. When you look at this security filter class, here I am setting here only, right? We are setting authentication here only. So same get context, I am getting the authentication in the user controller method. Security context holder, get context, get authentication. Whatever data I set in the filter class, that data I am taking here as an authentication object. From the authentication object, there is one method called principal. That principal return the user detail. That principal is a user detail object. I am converting as a user detail object. From that user detail object, I am taking the username. Then if that username contains role information, we can print that role information also. User details dot get authorities. Get authorities. It will print if that user is having a role. Okay. Now we understand what's going on the part of JWT. First, we are authenticating. Using authenticating, we are generating access token. Then we are using that access token for every rested point call. For every rested point call, the JWT filter validating that access token. If this access token is valid, setting that user information in the security context loader, then our subsequent target rest endpoint getting called. In the rest endpoint, if you want to access that currently logged in the user information, you can take it from the security context. Okay. So authentication control for authenticate or generating an access token. User control for the user control. In the user control, I have an endpoint. That endpoint for accessing the user data. Accessing the user data. This endpoint we cannot call without authorization. That authorization happening in JWT filter. Okay. Any questions? In the JWT util, I have an extract username. It's a utility method for manipulating an access token. JWT token to manipulate a JWT token. In this JWT util.java, I have extract username. From the token, I can get the extract username. From the token, I get the expiration date, issued at date. Also, we can construct the JWT token using create token. Using this method, I am generating and manipulating the access token. Okay. Any questions? It is bored or interesting, guys? You understand?
Interesting only, sir, but so many predefined things are there, sir. Methods.
Correct. Yeah, we have to. That will come by practice. Okay, we need to work. So for that purpose, I am giving you one assignment for everybody. Okay, for everybody. The same thing only we need to do. I want this authenticate, right? For this authenticate method, we are generating an access token, refresh token. Okay. Let's assume that your access token expired. Access token is expired. After expiring the access token, I want to generate new access token by providing refresh token. So whenever you generate an access authenticate, whenever you call this authenticate, you will have two tokens, right? We have a refresh token also. Now we need to write a one more endpoint. Okay, refresh token. This will generate new access token by providing refresh token. Okay, how do you design the endpoint? So if you want to generate new access token, what you have to provide?
A refresh token
as an input. So the authentication info, we have a refresh token as a one more attribute. So you can use this as a request body. I'll give you the steps. Please try by yourself. Okay. Use authentication request info as a request body. After giving the request body, what you have to do? We need to validate, right? For this, we need to use this particular authenticate method, authentication manager.authenticate method. But we don't have a username. Here in this case, we are taking from the client username and the password. But in this case, we don't have this guy. We have only a refresh token. Okay, what you have to do for this use JWT utils. From the JWT utils, there is a one method called extract user. Extract user, right? Extract user. From this extract user, you can get the what is that method?
Username we can get.
Yeah.
Sir, here at line number 34, that claims resolution operator get subject means it's JDK 8 feature, sir.
Yeah, yeah. From the claims, we can say double colon, we can call particular method. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, now we need to get this username, right, from this access token, from this refresh token. Okay, we need to use this particular method. Username, then use this username in this line, in this same thing. Use this username here, load by username. This will give you all the details. Then you need to call this method. Once through this method, authenticated, we need to use this method. Now you should not use this method because this creating a both access token, refresh token, right? We should not generate refresh token. You need to generate only access token. For that, you need to remove the code which is related to generate refresh token. Create a new method, and remove in that method which is related to refresh token. Then call that method here. Call here your new method which generating a access token, new access token. Okay. These are steps you need to follow to implementing a generating new access token by providing refresh token. If you stuck up in middle, you don't know how to proceed. For that, yesterday I already shared billing system, right? Here, user public controller. The user public controller, there is an endpoint called refresh token. Refresh token, whatever steps I am saying that I am given here. Okay, you don't have to go through all the things. Okay, don't bypass all JWT stuff, that is DB stuff. I'm saving token database. In your case, you don't have to save the database. Ignore that those lines. Just to go through here. If you stuck anywhere, just go through here. How I'm generating a refresh token. Okay, now all you have to do is you need to create one more method based on these steps, right? Based on this instruction, you have to create one more method. That method should generate a new access token. That's it. Try by yourself. If you have doubt, go through this method. Otherwise, I will show it tomorrow. Okay. Any questions? Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it, share this video to your friend circle, click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.